An 18-year-old wrongfully arrested by the North Charleston Police Department has finally reached a settlement with the city of North Charleston. We told you about Shanice Mitchell back in November. News 2's Olivia Parson sat down with Shanice and her mother in an interview you'll see only on 2.
They got the wrong person.
Shanice Mitchell had big plans for her senior year. She was an amazing basketball player, an honor roll student, and involved in several extracurriculars. But that all changed on October 29th.
I called my mom, and she was like, the police at the house, and they're like, you weren't involved in a fight, and they're trying to come get you and everything.
In May of 2019, a fight broke out after the Baptist Hill prom, a high school Shanice didn't go to. Nearly 6 months later, Shanice says North Charleston police showed up at her door with a warrant for her arrest. Shanice was later put in handcuffs, no questions asked.
And even the lady that was doing my fingerprints and stuff in jail, she was like, you're so calm and everything. And I'm like, because I know I didn't do anything and I'm in here for no reason.
Shanice played AAU basketball. That weekend the fight broke out, she was out of town for a tournament, something her coach tried to vouch for.
She had the roster of the information showing, you know, that we had proof that she wasn't here.
Mom Deborah Mitchell says she tried several times to defend her daughter's innocence.
We don't know where they got her name from.
The photo of Shanice's mugshot went viral around her school. After her arrest, Shanice says she stopped hearing from schools that originally were scouting her for college.
I had multiple different schools looking at me.
I apologized to her. You know, if she did something wrong,
I would admit to it.
The detective leading the case, Simon Andrews, retired 2 days after Shanice's wrongful arrest.
You're not being held accountable for what you did, so they let you retire from the department. And you're about to destroy someone's life. And you hear about this a lot.
News 2 reached out to the North Charleston Police Department for comment from Chief of Police Reggie Burgess. The department declined to an interview. Fortunately, Shanice was recently able to reach a settlement with the city for the 9 hours she spent in jail. Her attorney, Mark Pepper, issued a statement that reads in part, "This cannot be tolerated and should serve as a reminder to all law enforcement of how important it is to perform a full and thorough investigation before taking away someone's freedom." Going forward, Shanice hopes the department reaches out.
I'm actually a caring, generous person that owns up to what they do.
Olivia Parsons, Count on 2.